Ramsey Center. It's time for Catamount basketball. In rivalry fashion, they've talked about it all year long. Appalachian State swept Western Carolina a year ago. Today, the Catamounts are in full force trying to keep that undefeated home record alive. And the battle for second place in the North, let the battle for the old Mountain Jug begin here on Catamount Sports. And Brian, we sure got a dandy here this afternoon.
Yeah, we do. This is a tough app team. It's always been a rivalry, and they play tough every time. You can't expect an easy win by either side.
And, you know, we talked about the big win that Western Carolina had not that long ago, Thursday night. A big-time game against Davidson. And, you know, they played it all on the line. A lot of scoring from a lot of different people.
Yeah, they did. The whole team worked well together. It wasn't just one player scoring. It was the entire team. You know, you had players coming off the bench scoring, and it was a great game overall.
One thing that's really impressed me about the Catamounts, the evolution of Trey Sumler. We talked about it last game. He didn't disappoint at all Thursday night.
No, he didn't. You know, he's just a redshirt freshman. He had to sit out last year, his first year playing, and every time I see him, he continues to get better. He never disappoints me at all.
How about this redshirt freshman, your second leading scorer behind Mike Williams? And it's interesting, you talk about a leading scorer. Very rarely do you put them in the category of leading assist man for the Catamounts. He is a big offensive weapon for them tonight.
Yeah, exactly. Mike Williams is outstanding. He can do it all. There's nothing that he can't do. He can get big rebounds. He can score at any point of the game. And like you just said, he can't.
Here he is.
I mean, their threes are key to that, and they're very good at shooting from downtown.
Appalachian State not quite coming in as hot. Catamounts having a three-game win streak. Appalachian State, Thursday night, they gave UNCG their first victory at home in Boone, but the Catamounts can't look at that at all because, you know, the Mountaineers will be coming out with vengeance here this afternoon.
Yeah, the Catamounts, we have to play them like they're apps. We have to play them like, you know, like we just lost to Greensboro. We can't let the Greensboro loss make us think that they're a weak team. They're not a weak team, and they're going to be even more fired up because they did just lose.
And we look last year, Butt's a big-time center for Appalachian State, a really big, strong guy. They don't have him this year, so the Catamounts now probably have the edge inside. And you know Richie Gordon's licking his chops to eat him up in the post.
Yeah, definitely. He's a big guy. And, you know, it's not just Richie Gordon. Last game against Elon, we got so many offensive rebounds, and that was a huge key last game. And I think it'll be a good key this game. You know, we got King, obviously Richie Gordon, and Gallagher as well down low. And that size is going to help us out a lot.
And the Catamounts are coached by Larry Hunter. And the job that he has done. And the Catamounts are coached by Larry Hunter. He's really done a good job in this group. And purple night, or purple day rather, in the Ramsey Center. Appalachian State has a handful of purple this afternoon.
Yeah, they do. This crowd is loud. The crowd loves it when App comes into town. And nobody misses this game. It's a huge game. Everybody's wearing purple. Fans are getting loud already. We haven't even started yet.
And the hype, no doubt. And, you know, we talk about it all year long. Who's going to win between App and Western Carolina tonight, or this afternoon, rather? It's all about earning bragging rights for a long time.
That is exactly true. And we don't play them again until late February. So those bragging rights, you know, will carry us a long way.
Talk about the effectiveness for, you know, this crowd
A
big start would be a big
Yeah, you can get the crowd going early, get the crowd on the team, and get the crowd fired up, and the team can be even more fired. But if you're the Mountaineers, you want to be the opposite.
Brent, as they well know, they've been here. They know this can be a raucous environment, and a quick start would be with the whole their confidence as well.
That's exactly the truth. If they start quick, the crowd's going to get down, the crowd's not going to be as loud, and that's what they need to do.
And you know,
Sam was a senior for Appalachian State. He would love to go out of his career with a win here at Ramsey Center. He would have been asked, but he would love to be able to say to your rival team.
Yeah, winning your rival team away is huge. I mean, that's even more bragging rights because you beat them at their own loud place.
And you talk about motivation factors if you needed any. It's for second position in the North behind the And not only that, if you look at the Catamounts, one out of their last 10, well, they're 1-9 in the last 10 ball games against the Appalachian State Club. Western wants to put that very to bed.
Okay, yeah, get on your feet. It's time to go to
the Western definitely not. We're undefeated. You know, that's great for the fans. The fans love watching the games, so if we can win at home, that's even better. And we're undefeated, and we'd love to keep it going.
Starters for the Catamounts, Richie Gordon, Gallagher, you know, not a big man in this offense or defense, right? But he does a lot of the intangibles that you look for.
He does. He hustles. He plays well on defense, and he's a big guy. He takes up space.
Another starter for the Catamounts, Mike Williams, we talked about Trey Sumler and Aruna Matumbo. And the spark he gave his team Thursday night coming off the bench, it was almost instantaneous. He came off the bench, Catamounts had 4 points.
Yeah, he got points, he got rebounds, he played big, and he played bigger than he had to do. It was just a bar, but he played like he was
four. Catamounts taking four. We're about ready to jump it up here in Ramsey. And what should be an afternoon of exciting basketball action. We're ready to bring it to you. Richie Gordon to do the tipping duties for the Catamounts. It'll be Williamson for the Mountaineers. Loose ball comes all the way back. Sims will corral it. Appalachian State will have the first crack at a score here. Catamount defense has been so impressive all year long. They got to keep that up against what can be a very potent offense in Appalachian
State.
Yeah,
they got to get in their face and not let them breathe. They just got to shut them down.
And Appalachian State has got a quick start, keeps them going at home. Early, Richie Gordon defense. Tough shot, but they're able to get it. And a good play by Appalachian State, high percentage shot early on.
Yeah, he went right to the basket, didn't waste any time, went right up, you know, Richie Gordon, and put up the first points of the game.
Hosley, a 6'6 junior for the Mountaineers, Gallagher now. He's going to work one-on-one. He's in the post. Turnaround, drop step, and traffic. Lost it for a second, and Appalachian State will regain possession. Good stealing again. He's in the good hands of the Catamount defense.
Yeah, the Catamounts, they always get the hands on the ball. They're a tall, long team, and it's tough to get those passes around.
One mistake, though, in the fast break. Catamounts are able to, they turn it over, trying to get a quick basket on the other end. Appalachian State will get the ball underneath their own basket. Early on, we've already seen a lot of action.
Yeah, I mean, we turn the ball over, but that's exactly what we want to do. We want to get in transition, play fast-paced offense, and get some easy buckets on the other end.
Again, they go to the right. This time it spins out.
Gallagher cleans up the board ahead to Trey Sumler. It'll be an interesting matchup. Sumler on Sims, senior redshirt freshman, going at it here tonight.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the age difference is huge, but Sumler's playing a great game, and I don't see that he's going to be totally shut down.
Ball goes out of bounds to the Mountaineers, and you almost get a sense that Western Carolina, you know, they're trying to get their win under them offensively, but we've seen that through them a lot this season.
Yeah, again, last game against Elon, it took a long time for us to get scoring, but once we did, we never let it go.
How about this? Spear! I have the mic! Mike Williams!
Yeah, there you go. Transition offense, easy, fast break bucket.
And not many people are going to outrun Mike Williams coast to coast, as that was a perfect dive on the fast break. And just like that, we're not enough.
Yeah, exactly. Like I just said, you know, once we start scoring, the first bucket's always the hardest, but once you get that, it gets a little bit easier from there on.
Carter tries to shoot three ball, short iron, and great sign for the Catamounts early, good perimeter defense.
Yeah, we can't let them get going on the three ball. I mean, they are really good three-point shooters, and once you let a team get hot from the three, it's really hard to keep up with.
Catamount shot won't go. Here come the Mountaineers. They also want to push tempo. A team that their offense is very fluid, a lot of motion in it.
Yeah, definitely. They also want to be up-tempo, and they're not going to just let the Catamounts do whatever they want on offense and defense.
Williams has it knocked away from him for a moment, kicks it out to Sumler, catches set up the half court. Sumler comes off the screen, pump fake, look for Richie Gordon, it's a kick violation. Catamounts will maintain possession. Really great idea early, pick and roll.
Yeah, that pick and roll is, you know, it's a simple thing, but it works time in and time out.
And the Catamounts use it a lot. Their Boggs, jump shot, you better
believe it.
No doubt about that one. Boggs, a lot of confidence in that stroke early on.
Yeah, that looks like a great shot. He definitely has confidence. He's only a freshman, but that was a great looking shot.
Catamounts jumping after an early 4-2 lead. And we have a whistle away from the ball. As Richie Gordon in there was getting his hand on the ball yet again, and we talk about how active this defense is. Catamount's really active with their hands, and you really got to be sharp playing them offensively.
Yeah, you can't throw lazy passes. You have to, you know, throw strong passes because we will get our hands on the ball.
Woods looking to control the half court for Appalachian State. Mike Williams on him. Mike now wants to pressure, grip the right side, and we have a foul. Mike Williams reaching in, trying to create yet
another. Catamount foul, number 12, Mike Williams, his first personal.
And that could be another big story for the Catamounts as we go forward. You know, fouls started to become a little bit of an issue in the second half against Elon. Mike Williams had four, Richie Gordon had four, eventually fouled out late in the contest. But the Catamounts, they can help themselves by not getting a foul.
Yeah, we have to not commit, you know, the lazy fouls, the reach-in fouls. You know, we got to make at least the fouls count, and if we can keep them out of foul trouble, that would be great.
One a senior for Appalachian State, but both have a world of talent.
Yeah, definitely. You had to know that Sims wasn't just going to let that three go unanswered.
That'll
bring
us to our first timeout. Catamounts have a 2-point lead.
Saturday, February 5th at 2 p.m.
The Catamounts
lose the UNC Greensboro Spartans for the
Battle of the Old Mountain Show.
Come
on, we'll be back by
this. Come support the Catamounts as we welcome back forward Catamount players and honor them for their accomplishments here.
Welcome back to the Rangers. Catamount offense really exploded toward the latter half of that four-minute segment. Catamount seemed to have their feet under them. You know, Appalachian State a good answer with the Sims three ball. I have a feeling it's going to be that back-and-forth matchup all night long.
Yeah, it's going to be a high-scoring game. You know, both teams aren't going to let the opposing team just score at will. It's going to be a close game, and it's going to be very exciting.
Fox dribbles out of the trap in the corner. Now he'll fire the three. And it is no good. Appalachian State may be a chance to run Woods. controlling it at the point at the moment for the Mountaineers.
That's one thing that's really helped Sims this year. He doesn't have to play that corner guard position all the time. He can move with a two guard. A big asset for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, definitely. You know, when the pressure is not all on you at the point guard position and trying to score, it's definitely huge. He can just, you know, play the game and doesn't have to be stressed.
Six on the shot clock. Sims works it over. Far corner, three ball off the back iron, no good. And if you're the Catamounts, that's the kind of offensive possession you want Appalachian State to have to settle for.
Yeah, definitely. If you can get the clock running down, the shot clock, force them to take a shot that maybe they didn't really want to take. That's perfect for the Catamount defense. They just got to get that rebound.
Good job.
Yeah, again, that defense was a very long defense and very quick defense. And they got the trap and just had nowhere to go at
all. I asked Catamount Sam Smith about, you know, the Appalachian State game. And I said, if you could find one word to describe playing Appalachian State, his response was simple and quick: warm. And that's exactly what the Catamounts are at right now. And they're showing it with their effort on the floor.
Yeah, it's a 7-5 game right now. Obviously, it's close. And both teams are going to war right now.
Woods will slow it down a little bit. Now he'll get it to Sims. Sims looking to either create his own offense or set up a teammate, something he also does very well. And we have a 3-second call. It'll be Catamount basketball. Gallagher, again, intangible, good defense.
Mitch Wood just got his first personal foul, and this defense, they will aggravate you. They, you know, they're always in your face, they don't let you breathe, and it'll aggravate you from time to time.
Sumler will bring it up, and he and Sims deadlocked at three as far as their scoring numbers go. How about Richie Gordon? No, that short jump shot won't go. Gallagher, rebound. Sumler, I'm sorry. Get him!
Yeah, these two ball clubs, they're going to leave everything out on the floor. They're going to give it everything they have, and we're seeing it already. You know, the big-time players are scoring early.
And I mean, you know, Sumler and Sims, they're already showing. We haven't played 6 minutes yet, and they're already playing as good as advertised.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, they're getting going early, and, you know, 14 minutes left in the quarter, and it's, you know, it's 10-7. It's still exciting, and the defense is still playing great. You know, it's a close game. Both defenses are playing well, and it's exciting right now.
Well, really, since that opening possession, it's been the Catamounts 10, Donald Sims 5. They got that first basket inside, but Sims having 5 of the Mountaineers, 7 points. But then you look for it, Trey Sumler has 6 of the Catamounts, 10.
Yeah, that is true. And honestly, for the Catamounts, if we can keep it so that Sims is the only one scoring, he's not going to be able to outscore the entire team. So, you know, as long as we can get the other players at bay, then I think we'll be okay.
3 ball off the back iron, let's go. Loose ball almost goes out of bounds. Appalachian State does corral it, and they'll work their way back into the offense.
Yeah, that was a great save by Appalachian State. It was about to go out of bounds on them, and he jumped out of bounds and saved the ball.
Appalachian State working in a foul. We'll see. This one is called on. It's on Sumler.
Foul on number 5.
And we talk about what another thing Sumler does so well. He goes inside, he fights for loose balls, and often he wrestles those big guys and wins loose balls.
Yeah, he does. He's a point guard, but he doesn't just stay around the perimeter. He doesn't mind getting inside, getting physical, and trying to get those rebounds for the Catamounts.
Appalachian State will again inbound it under their own basket. Richie Gordon will take a breather for the Catamounts as Boggs comes in along with Tawaski King.
and he's played a big part early on, especially recently for the Catamounts. A lot of big rebounds and a big body to account for in the post.
Yeah, Tawaski King is no small guy by any size. He's a big guy, he takes up space, and he's physical.
And second foul. And as he thought he had the block on Sims, and your Catamounts will put Sims at the free throw line, 80% free throw shooter, about as good as they come from the charity stripe.
Yeah, you don't want to get this guy on the free throw line. You can never guarantee points, but it's pretty close with him. He'll most likely score the points on the free throw line.
Referee pulls Sumler and Carter together, has a quick word with them. And you know, the officials know this is a rivalry. But I think so far they're doing a really good job fighting the ball. Maria is from Sims. And, you know, if you're Sims, don't look for the crowd not to let you know about it.
Yeah, they will let you know about it. They're going to be loud. They're going to get in your ear. And you can hear them. I mean, they're loud.
Second free throw from Sims on the way. He missed two. Maybe we get the announcer's curse there saying how good of a free throw shooter he was.
We must have. I mean, I didn't expect him to miss two. I was expecting 2 points on the board. But, you know, Catamounts aren't going to mind him missing them.
Mike, what do you tell about that move? Are you kidding me?
Like we just said, Mike Williams can do it all. He's a great player, he's quick, and that was a great move by Mike Williams.
I mean, you can't really say it's bad defense on the end of Appalachian State. It's just an incredible play by an incredible athletic player in Mike Williams.
Yeah, you can't defend that. There's nothing you could have done there.
Jumper that just short won't go. This ball comes to Sims, and the Appalachian State Mountaineers will try to work 3-on-2. Catamounts now get back drive, nicely done by Carter, and he quiets the crowd momentarily, going into a rip on the game.
Yeah, that was a great pass by Sims right to Carter, and Carter put a nice move to get the layup.
Sumler at the point. Coach Hunter, a lot of confidence in this young man, as we can see, leaving him in there with 2 fouls early on in this first half.
Yeah, he got 2 fouls early, but he's leaving him in the game and trust him that he'll be all right.
Carter had to work for that fast break ball that he bought against Mike Williams, but he did get it to go. Mountaineers have trimmed it to 1 as the Catamounts now look for an answer on the offensive end. Mike Williams going to work. Needs help. King gives it to him, and King is fouled as he was looking for a wide open somewhere in the corner. Smart foul for Appalachian State that time.
Appalachian State,
yeah.
Number 0.
He had a wide open guy for 3, and they didn't let it get into him. But if you look, I mean, it's 12-11. Both teams are scoring, and it's you can never count the team down.
Lead us to immediate timeout. 12-11, a dogfight, or a catfight, as the Catamounts would call it here in the Ramsey Center. Come back for more hardwood action.
To get your cat match now at catamountsports.com. Or call the Athletic Ticket Office at 1-800-34-UWCU.
Appalachian State doing a good job at, you know, not only answering points, but they're starting to create turnovers of their own defensively.
Yeah, both defenses are doing well at creating turnovers.
And right on cue, Sims gets a tip, fast break opportunity for Appalachian, and they got it. A nice coast-to-coast break run by Sims, doing what he does best, orchestrate in traffic. And, you know, not looking to score that time, set up his teammate for an easy noose.
Yeah, he did. You know, he played unselfishly, and they got 2 points on the board. I believe it's Ross's first points, and it was a big three by Preston Ross.
And the crowd certainly enjoyed that one. As a catch, they're loud and on their feet. Catamounts go inside, or Mountaineers do jump hook over King, not easily done. And off the back iron, no good. Catamounts want to run, and they'll turn it over. The lead pass was a little too far out of the reach.
Or
misses from Appalachian State to easy baskets on the other end.
Yeah, I don't mind. I love this up-tempo style of play that they have right now. You know, they just need to make the passes a little bit better, and, you know, I like the style, though.
Sims will bring it across field, look, dump it inside on Richie Gordon. Richie Gordon standing his ground, tough shot, got it to go. Good strong move that time by Williamson for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, he didn't back down. I mean, Richie Gordon's a big guy, but, you know, he took him down low and made a tough basket.
Richie Gordon now trying to avenge, hands it off to Mike for Mutombo. Mutombo finds a gap, easy layup, and he slides into the lane to get easy layups like that, waiting for the hole to open, and boy, he didn't miss it.
Yeah, that was an uncontested layup, and, you know, it'll probably be the easiest shot he'll get all day.
How about King Cole getting a tough defensive board? Here comes someone in the Catamounts, alley-oop for Richie Gordon. And how about that save? Not a good pass, Richie Gordon, able to save it and get it back to Sumler. Catamounts set up the offense.
Yeah, that was a great save by Gordon. If he doesn't make that play, it's out of bounds and another turnover for the Catamounts.
Sumler gets up from Mutombo. Mutombo calls the play looking for a screen, he's got it. And Gordon pops out of pick and roll, good defense from Appalachian, he couldn't get it to him. Gordon has a mismatch, and they stole it away from him. Gordon was looking for the foul, didn't get it. Sims, hard press down the other side.
Double.
And one of the fastest as they come is the Southern Conference, and Sims gets coast to coast so quickly.
Yeah, that was a great layup, and he got in there, seemed pretty easily, but, you know, we just got to get in there and make it a little more difficult.
Cole's shot is blocked. Appalachian on the other end. Well, it's a rebound. That won't go. Richie Gordon will corral it with the Catamounts. And now the Catamounts slowing things up here, trying to get their offense back under the control. And, you know, you want smart, quality positions. Appalachian State not very deep in the inside. And we've seen that early, Catamounts will probably continue to pound the inside.
Yeah, with Richie Gordon in the game, you're always going to want to get him the ball. He's the big man, and you got to feed him the basketball.
Pass got deflected, intended for Ross, and the Mountaineers will take advantage. 5-on-4 the other way. Sims over Gordon, no. The putback is there. And the Mountaineers have their first lead, second lead, rather, since 2-0. They now lead 19-17 with just under 8 to go.
Yeah, that was a great offensive rebound by the Mountaineers, and, you know, he got an easy layup because of that rebound.
Sumler shot won't go. Another defensive rebound for the Mountaineers. Sims looking to push again. Fadeaway jumper, and they're going to call the foul on Sumler, who thought he got a lot of basketball. And we'll see if that was on Sumler. If that's Sumler, it's his third.
Yeah, that was a strong take to the basket.
And five,
it is on Sumler, and that is his third foul. And I hope they can keep out of foul trouble.
The first timeout, Catamounts trail by 3 when they come back.
The men return home Thursday.
Welcome back to the Ramsey Center. Numbers, rather, pretty even as you expect. Appalachian State a little higher from the floor, 45%. And the Catamounts are 43%. Big score for the Catamounts, a lot of fire from beyond the arc. 3 of 6 compared to Apps 1 of 7.
Yeah, those threes are helping us stay in the game. It's a a two-point game right now, and those threes have been huge.
Sims knocks down the free throw, as that'll be Appalachian State's first free throw make of the game. Sims 1-for-3 now from the stripe. Catamounts yet to shoot a free throw here this half. And they continue to pound it inside, and you got to think those will come eventually.
Yeah, we have a big lineup, and they'll get to the line eventually.
Sims knocks both of those down. Keaton Cole running the point now for the Catamounts. Somewhere out with three fouls into Mike Williams. Jump shot. No good. Rebound ball. Oh, yes, on the glass, getting him the deuce.
Yeah, that was a great offensive rebound, and put it right back up, didn't take his time, and he got us two.
That's another thing, Appalachian State, four of them early on. That was the Catamounts' fourth as the equalizer on the offensive glass. A lot of hard action going on inside, fighting for loose ball. Both teams really doing a good job attacking the offensive glass.
Yeah, both teams are getting offensive rebounds, and it's a strong game right now.
Pass forced inside, intercepted by the Mountaineers. Blocked by Gordon, second attempt is good. From Hosley. Hunter wants a timeout to talk it over.
With 6:47.
Mountaineers have opened up a 4-point lead. And, you know, we see it. Catamounts in transition. Just a little bit too quick decision.
Yeah, we're getting a little bit crazy with the passes. We're trying to make good plays. And, you know, we just need to mentally just slow it down a little bit.
On fast break when you have two-on-one situations. You want to make that one guy commit. Mike Williams didn't quite make him commit, and it probably caused a turnover.
Yeah, he didn't exactly commit, and he threw it, you know, he threw it right to the defender. And, you know, but I like the aggressive style of play. You got to go for that two-on-one every time.
Mike Williams doubled immediately, leaving Cole wide open. And that'll make him pay. And it'll get a knockdown for
Yeah, you can't leave Keaton Cole wide open. He can make that three, and he's a great shooter, and they left him open, and he capitalized.
Swing pass, corner, three ball, Carter. He's done that as of late, and he continues his streak there. Appalachian over their second shot from downtown, and Sims had the first.
And both of the threes from Appalachian State have been direct answers from Western three.
Mike Williams, no good. And this place is about to erupt. Mike Williams, yeah, struggling here early, shooting the ball, but he's done a lot otherwise. Here he comes again. Skip pass, Keaton Cole.
Yeah, exactly. We got on fast break. You know, he slowed it down. He drove up the court, got the guy to commit, made the easy pass, layup.
Richie Gordon said to check back in the game. Twoski King, though, putting strong minutes on the inside for the Catamounts.
Yeah, he's a big guy, and the coach trusts him when he's on the floor.
Forces a tough to impossible shot. And they'll say the ball was last touched by the Catamounts. Catamounts agree with him.
And Twoski King taking a bunch of third rest after
a lot of hard press defense. As we saw right there, Appalachian State had a lot of work to do if they were going to get it over King.
Yeah, he didn't let an easy basket. He had his hands straight up, didn't commit a foul, played tough defense. Great, great defense by King.
Sims lobs in the inbound pass, and he's covered up immediately, and Cole may have covered him up too well, as there's a foul on the baseline. But we see that a lot with this Appalachian State offense. He'll inbound the ball, but then it's coming right back to him. Cole's having nothing to do with it.
Yeah, they're going to get him the ball as many times as they can. You know, he's the orchestrator on the floor, and you got to get the ball in his hands.
Sims looking for an option to get another lob pass. Again, he'll cut the baseline, pops out of the way. Cole's there. Scored for a check on the inside, but they're going to call a goaltend. It'll be 2 points
basket good by the Mountaineers.
This defense, they're all over the place, seemingly all the time.
Yeah, Richie Gordon, he was so close to having the huge block, and the crowd would have gone crazy, but it was a goaltend, and they called it, and they got a call right.
Mike Williams, skip past the board, can't get it.
Again, so big, gets the offensive rebounds, and that's what sparked this last game against Elon, and that was a great rebound. Hopefully he can maybe get us another spark.
You know, those one-on-one games with Nephew Dikembe may have something to do with having to play big. About four quick points, and the Catamounts are in fact locked up.
Yeah, he's right now creating that spark. That was a great drive, right between two defenders, right, and he made the basket. Huge layup for the Catamounts.
Williams had a goal! And how about Nick Horton getting the turnover, but Mike Sims getting the ball and not getting on Sims' leg. And you can just see the frustration on Sims' face. Not often does he have a center pick his pocket.
No, he was not happy about that. But this crowd's going crazy. The crowd loves it, and it was a great defensive play by Richie Gordon.
Cole looking to get the regain the Catamount lead. Richie Gordon on the inside. Can he do it offensively? Jump hook, you better.
Richie Gordon!
He got the matchup he wanted. He went down low, and he made the basket. Great play by Gordon. Back-to-back great plays by Richie Gordon.
One thing that you gotta love, especially on the offensive end, when he gets there, you see a lot of big guys that want to hesitate down there. No hesitation from big Richie Gordon.
No, he went right down to the basket. Didn't take any time. You know, if you get the defense time, they'll double-team you. You know, he just went right to it, made the basket.
Box picks up his first. Mountaineers will be on the line when you come back. Cats up by two.
Yeah, Sims is a great free throw shooter, and the Catamounts definitely don't want him on the line.
It looks like it'll be Hosley at the line for the Mountaineers shooting two. First free throw perfect as he strips the nylon. Few Appalachian State fans politely applaud. They're in a strong minority here, though. Catamounts really brought the house as far as the crowd support tonight.
Yeah, they're getting loud. This is the biggest crowd we've had yet all year, and you know the Appalachian State players can hear it. They can't even think right now.
Tie game at 30 as both free throws down the bottom of the net. Mike Williams looking over Box. Cole thought about a deep three, thinks better of it. Look at this swing. How about the ball movement? Leading three, get there! And ball movement, key on that possession.
That was perfect passes. They went from one side of the court to the other, and Appalachian State couldn't keep up with them. They found a wide open Aruna Mutombo for the easy bucket and the foul.
Mutombo to complete the three-point play the old-fashioned way. No problem there. Catamounts 1-1 from the charity stripe. We talked about it. Strong take inside. You get rewarded with a triple line.
Yeah, Aruna Mutombo, he is creating that spark. He scored 7 points. I mean, you know, 7 of the past 9 points for Western has been scored by Aruna Mutombo.
Sim swings it now into the paint. Back outside to the Mountaineers. And active defense yet again, making it difficult. Jump shot in and out won't go. How about this? Mutombo wrestling the center for the rebound, forcing the jump ball. Catamounts will get the ball back.
He played big on that defensive rebound. He wasn't going to let go, and Western gets the ball back because of the tie.
Textbook, good box out that time from Mutombo. Cleaning the glass, rewarding in a Catamount possession. Cole orchestrating the offense. See if they can move the ball as nicely as they did last time. Gordon on the post. He's going to go to work one-on-one with Hosley. Double comes, jump hook, won't go. And the double was almost too late that time for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, we got down to Gordon again.
Dunk attempt blocked from behind by Richie Gordon. And no basket on the seemingly put back. And everything's coming difficult right now for the Mountaineers. Williams, jump shot. Short arms, it won't go. Sims trying to push it back for the Mountaineers. Drive and a hard foul. But Larry Hunter talked about that. He said if they foul him, we don't want them to have any chance of converting a three-point play.
Yeah, definitely. If you're going to foul, make it a hard foul. You know, don't do an illegal foul, but make it tough and don't let them get that three-point play.
And Richie Gordon comes over and talking over to Larry Hunter. And here we'll take a seat. Velocity King played some big minutes earlier. We'll check back in. Sets in the line for the Appalachian State Mountaineers. Shooting two. 1-1 rather well with this guy. It's almost like shooting two. Knocks down the first one, no problem.
Yeah, after missing his first two, he's hit three straight, and you know he's back to his form at the free throw line.
Second free throw on the way, and that one also hits nothing but nylon, and the Mountaineers have cut it to one, trying to answer that great move by Mutombo a short while ago for the Catamount offense. King now working on the inside, he'll set the screen, and double comes. King Cole didn't see him on the pick and roll. Boggs drives, jump shot, get it! Jump shot! And he is fired up going down to the inside of the floor.
That was a great shot by Boggs. He went like he was going to drive to the hole, stepped back, made a great shot.
Yeah, that's something that, you know, Sims is used to seeing that, but usually on his end, and the Catamounts ding him up. Mike Williams on Sims. And for the Catamounts, you got to think that's a good defensive matchup. A lot of speed in that matchup as well.
Yeah, there is. You know, Sims is a very fast player, and if you're going to put somebody on him, Mike Williams is definitely a great player to have on defense.
Drive to the rack, Mutombo swatted it away, and now there's a foul.
There's a Catamount foul
on Kowalski King, and he wrestling for the ball, a lot of bumping down low, and a lot of contact. Both teams are having nerd every inch on the post.
Yeah, that was a tough play, and you know King was just getting physical, trying to get that ball for the Catamounts, and ended up picking up the foul, but nothing's easy.
Hosley's first free throw, the 1-1, rattles out. Williams gobbles up the rebound. Quick pass, Boggs, thought about the three. And King looked for it in the post. He couldn't get it to him. Good denial that time by Williamson, who was on Boggs, not letting the interior pass come through for the Catamounts.
Yeah, he wanted that shot at first, but the defense came right up to him, and he couldn't shoot it.
Loose ball foul on the Mountaineers on the drive. And when you're trying to stop a guy like Mutombo or Mike Williams, sometimes grabbing the jersey is the only option.
Yeah, they're so quick, they're so fast. You know, you got to do whatever you can to make sure they don't get an easy layup.
And both of them, their first step is so quick. They're so, once they make a decision where they want to get, a lot of times in a very big hurry. Fox again, trying to continue his hot streak, shot won't go, rebounded by the Mountaineers. They want to push tempo, kick out. They thought about a three. We're under a minute here in the first half. Down low, inside, back door, two-handed shot.
And Williamson
was leaving no doubt that time.
That was a huge slam by him, and we talked about this last game. Going into the half, you want to get the momentum, and that could have been it right there. That was a huge dunk by him, and he's trying to get the momentum going into half.
Calling the offensive play. Catamounts had a chance to go 2-for-1, but you know, you'd rather have a quality possession than a rush possession. Catamounts, they can milk it down to 13, 12 seconds or so. Kowalski King looking for Mike Williams, that would go inside of Mutombo. Mutombo 1-on-1. Crowd wants him to exceed the mismatch, and a foul. Williamson for the Mountaineers can't believe it. And the Catamounts, we get the ball into the basket. And now the shot clock's off. Now the Catamounts can't play for that last shot.
Yeah, we'll be getting the last shot on this one. And, you know, getting a shot right here would be huge. Yes, we're up by one. But to get the last shot of the half is a huge momentum builder. And you got to remember, Keaton Cole's been doing the point guarding, and he's been doing a great job right now. But we need to get this last shot.
Boggs thought about a quick triple, thought better of it. We'll get it to Mike Williams. We'll set it up. Larry Hunter calling the play from the bench. He's picked. Pocket pick, quick dunk. Over to Appalachian State. A big play that time
for Mountaineers.
4-14
Yeah. The momentum is now on Appalachian's side. A huge dunk. They've had back-to-back dunks. And they now take a one-point lead. And, you know, Mike Williams is trying to do a drive, but he ended up getting picked. It was a great job by Williams, but it just ended up going Appalachian State's way.
Action-packed first half.
proves to be nothing different in the second half. Come on back
as we go to the battle of the WCUZ.
Turnover without letting them know. They're going to hear it the rest of the game.
Sumler running the point for the Catamounts, swings it over to Mike Williams. Have Gallagher on the wing, and Mike Williams swings it over to Sumler. They'll set up the half-court offense with 13 on the shot clock. Long pass into Gallagher. Looking down low, kick out Sumler. Almost lost the handle, three on the shot clock. Got to get a shot, how about that? Drawing contact, even though it was a tough shot, drawing contact, earning a trip to the free throw line.
Yeah, he had 1 second left on the shot clock. Great job getting that foul, because he wasn't going to get a great shot. He had good defense, but he forced a foul, and now he's got two free throws.
Using the aggression of a player like Sims, he knocks that first one, gave that little head fake. Sims wanted to swat that ball out of the gym. Bad news for Appalachian, Sumler never let it go.
No, and someone just made his first free throw, makes the second, 2 points for Catamounts.
Catamounts regained the lead, 39-38, and back and forth they continue to go in the hardwood battle for the Old Mountain Jug.
We've had many lead changes, many ties. Both teams are fired up. Both teams are giving it their all. It's, you know, it's going to keep going back and forth.
Sims, tough three ball at the top of the key. Sumler with a rebound. Sumler to Mike Williams, spot up three, no good. Out of bounds, and it'll be Appalachian State basketball. Boggs, a little surprise, thought it went all out of Appalachian, but Boggs knocked it away from him. Good aggressive attempt on the offensive glass.
Yeah, he almost had it. The crowd, you know, agreed with you. The crowd didn't think it was, but it's whatever the referees call. That's what really matters, and they called Appalachian State ball.
One thing that I've really been impressed with, especially watching this possession for Appalachian, Sims moving without the basketball. He creates havoc on the defense, weaving his way through defenders, and a lot of times it creates easy baskets for Sims, and Sims, when he gets them, he can rarely miss.
Yeah, he always is moving, he's always playing hard, and it makes it very tough on the defense.
Williams drive blocked out of bounds. He'll stay down here with the Catamounts as they look to regain the lead. Another lead change here in this ball game. Comes out to Gordon, swing pass Gallagher. Boggs, Williams, triple, short irons, and Gordon offensive glass. Gordon, reverse
play!
And that was a great rebound by Richie Gordon, and then great move to go to the baseline, go to the other side of the basket, and make the easy layup. Great play by Richie Gordon.
Gallagher on Williamson. Jump hook won't go. Out of bounds to the Catamounts. And Carter kind of rolling his eyes at that call. Richie Gordon, a lot to handle on the post, fighting for the offensive glass.
Yeah, Richie Gordon, he flew in there, got his hands on the rebound, and made it go out of bounds on Appalachian State. Great play by Gordon once again.
Sumler slowing it down, working the point for the Catamounts. Mike Williams springs free. We'll try the three again, and he's short this time. Quick drive and jump stop. Won't go for the Mountaineers. Gallagher rips it down.
Great defense by Catamounts right there.
Sumler went right at Sims. They really get fouled. Finished it off.
What a drive right there by Sumler. Went to the basket, didn't take any time, went aggressively, and he got the foul, and then made an acrobatic move and made the basket as well. Great play by Sumler.
As good as his finesse game is, that play right there also showing he can be physical on a drive. Sumler finishes.
He plays big, he plays strong, he gets rebounds, he does it all. He's a great player, and he'll continue to improve. He's just a redshirt freshman, and he improves every game I see. He's going to keep improving, and he's going to be a great player for years to come.
And to show you how close this game has been, the largest margin
tie for the largest margin this game's ever seen. 4 points. Catamounts with a 4-point lead here. Drive, Carter. Nice take for the Mountaineers. And rather short-lived, the lead for the Catamounts cut in half.
Yeah, again, you just said that was the biggest lead is a 4-point game. And then Appalachian State comes right back, answers. And, you know, they're not going to let us get, you know, a 6-point lead, an 8-point lead. They're going to keep it close.
Gallagher taking it inside. Turnaround jumper won't go. Carter with the board for the Mountaineers.
That was a nice, strong play by Gallagher. Just couldn't let, just did, barely missed it. But it was a strong, nice play.
Trying to drive on Mike Williams. And now they'll skip it inside Williamson. And he is fouled on the inside. Williamson was knocked to the floor that time. And that'll lead us to our first meeting of timeout.
Blake Gallagher, his first personal.
Bring your big boy pads, it's physical in the paint here for the Battle of the Orange Catamounts.
Be sure to mark your calendars for January 29th. The Catamount Women's Basketball Pizza Game is coming up. The Catamount Women's Basketball Team will be joining other women's teams across the nation.
Welcome back to the Ramsey Center. Catamounts have a 2-point lead. Appalachian State at the line. We mentioned it before we went to break, a lot of physical play on the inside.
Yeah, there aren't going to be any easy baskets for either teams. Both physical and it's going to be tough. You have to, you know, be physical or else it's just not going to happen. You got to be physical in this game.
The phrase, you're going to have to earn your points in the paint. It elevates when you come to a rivalry game like we're in today.
Yeah, it definitely does. Both teams, you know, they don't like each other, both, and they're going to get physical. They're not going to let easy baskets go. You're going to have to earn your points from the free throw line.
Williamson misses his first free throw. A 62.8% free throw shooter on the year, short on the mark. That would rather go out. Gordon cherry picked the rebound. Sumler wants to push. Mike Williams swings it back over. Sumler, three ball, won't go. Gordon tips off the rebound. Went right to Antoine Carter of the Appalachian State Mountaineers. Carter drive, coast to coast. That'll be an and one. Carter, a strong take, saw Gallagher off balance, didn't hesitate to go right at it.
Yeah, he went right to his body, picked up the foul, and then made the layup as well. It's a tied-up game. He can now take the lead for another lead if he makes the free.
Gallagher will check out. Ross comes back in, and the Mountaineers' chance to take a lead. Carter, 74% free throw shooter on the year for the Appalachian State. Free throw is good, and the Catamounts trail by one, and yet another lead change here in what has been a back-and-forth battle all afternoon long.
It has been a crazy game. Both teams are hustling, and I have no idea who's going to win this game. It's going to come down to who wants it.
Coming in for the Catamounts, number 22, Haruna.
Ball comes out of bounds. Batumba will check in for the first time in the second half. Here with 15:10 to go, Boggs will take a seat and get a breather for the Catamounts. Pass comes out, Ross. Mike Williams looking to set up Richard Gordon. How about that? Ross, nobody saw him coming down the baseline.
That was a great pass, a great look, and a great finish for the alley-oop. Great play. The crowd loves it. They're into it. A great play.
And what the crowd loves to get more than that, Catamounts have the lead again. Carter on the inside for the Mountaineers, going to work from the tumble. Pull-up jump shot, that won't go. Ross lost the handle on the rebound. Williams stuck it back in for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, he got an easy layup. You know, Ross had it in his hands, slipped away, and it ended up giving Appalachian an easy bucket.
Sumler looking to set up Gordon on the double team. Nice pass, and a hack down low. That'll send, try to see who it was shooting for the
Mountaineers. I believe it was Sumler.
Appalachian State foul on number 11. Great
movement. He sets up Richie Gordon, and right away he looks to create offense, moving without
number
a pass ball. Run up by someone in strong tape.
Again, you know, our point guard down low, creating, you know, a foul. That's huge for such a, you know, a smaller a guy down low, but he's playing big.
Knocks the free throw home. We're knotted up at 47. Sumler will look to get his second free throw, and he does. Carolina Catamounts regain the lead. And the Appalachian State Mountaineers, this possession seemingly slowing it up a little bit. Now they'll pick up the tempo. Carter swings it back up top. And now they get the ball on the tumble. He's doubled and fouled. Much to the dismay of Richie Gordon. And the Catamount faithful. But a good aggressive defense, as we talked about, not getting anything out of the inside.
No, they're trying to get the, you know, the steal and maybe an easy bucket. You know, he just barely missed just getting the ball, got him a little bit, and they'll go to the free throw line now.
Catamounts are saying Carter back to the free throw line. First free throw is pure, and the Mountaineers have knotted it up yet again. And one thing we talked about, Trey Sumner, you know, missed a lot of time in that first half. Foul trouble, making up for it so far in the second half.
Yeah, he hasn't committed another foul yet, and if he can keep that up, then you'll see him in here for most of the rest of the game.
They knocked down the free throw, so Appalachian State back up top by a point as Sumner will bring it across on man-to-man pressure. Sumner beats his man and then looks to set up the pick and roll. Mike Williams comes and will feed it to Gordon. Gordon double team comes, dribbles out of trouble, and Mike Williams swings it. Matumbo for three. No. Long rebound comes the Mountaineers, and they want to. Mountaineers have been the ones wanting to push tempo all game long. No change here. And it's starting to heat up. Carter's starting to heat up a lot for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, he has. You've called his name many times, you know, recently as of late, and we got to stop him. We can't let him get hot because he'll cause problems.
They'll set up Ross on the paint. Ross trying to go to work. Tough jump shot won't go. Richie Gordon rebound won't go. Mountaineers coming back the other way.
And I think the crowd wanted a foul, but the refs didn't blow the whistle, and play goes on.
And they will get a foul on this end. This one will be on Preston Ross. As the Catamounts will huddle inside the lane, try to work out
what they want to do defensively here.
Appalachian State enjoying their largest lead of the game at 3 points.
Yeah, they got a 3-point lead. They have the ball now. They're going to look to try to score, you know, make it a 5-point lead. But, you know, this defense is going to try to stop them.
And we've already almost equaled the foul total from the first half. 14 fouls for the Catamounts, 3 for the Mountaineers. You know, exercising how physical it is. And Ross will get the rebound. He'll swing it out. Mike Williams on the ground. Mike Williams puts the foul, and he'll shoot a pair. Great awareness by Ross getting it in the corner.
That was a great play by Ross. He went out, he saved it. Not only did he save it, but he threw the pass to lead Mike Williams to the bucket.
And on top of that, we're going to add a technical foul for Appalachian State. And we'll see who that one is on. A little frustration there. And we'll see who picked up the technical here momentarily. We do know Mike Williams will have 2 free throws. It'll be interesting here who Larry Hunter will send out to shoot the technicals. The way he could play, and I would think it would be Trey Sumner.
Yeah. Sumler's been hot, he's been making his free throws, and I don't see any other player on the line.
His first personal.
Harley will pick,
and
Harley
double technical foul is going to
pick up
on the Catamounts number 12, Mike Williams.
Mike Williams also picking up a technical foul. So this rivalry really starting to heat up here in the second.
Yeah, both teams are getting physical, both teams are getting frustrated with each other. They just picked up a double technical, and you know, it's getting physical.
And since it's a double technical, Appalachian State was in their team huddle thinking
Mike Williams just picked up his third foul. And he's got to keep it cool because you can't get him with 4 fouls and have to take him out of the game.
Mike Williams will look to knock down 2 free throws here for the Catamounts after a good feed on the bench. That's that first. Good awareness, by the way, realizing Ross had control of the ball and then sprinting down the floor
And then good awareness by the Catamounts finding him on the fast break.
Yeah, he went right to the hole, didn't hesitate, picked up the foul, and now he's, you know, he's working on 2 points for the Catamounts.
And he completes it. Both free throws are good. Lead back to one. And well, it'll be interesting to see. You know, the Catamounts don't really seem to mind the fast pace that the Mountaineers want to play with here. But Appalachian State has had a lot of success all year long running up and down the floor.
Yeah, the Catamounts, that is their style too. You know, they don't mind running. And, you know, they got it to a one-point lead. And both teams, they'll get a lead, and then the other team will answer.
They're going to call a foul on Ross, count the basket. And Hosley, right after the technical foul, putting that behind him, going to work offensively for the Mountaineers.
And they just got their three-point lead back, and with another free throw, can make it a four-point lead.
If they do make it a four-point lead, it would equal the largest lead of the game for the Mountaineers. It's good.
Clipping in for the Catamounts, number 34, Blake Gallagher.
Gallagher will check in for Preston Ross for the Catamounts. Fresh legs in there, and Larry Hunter said one thing he really likes about this team, and he feels confident with 10 or 11 guys on his roster setting him out in game situations if need be.
Yeah, we are a very deep team, and you know, he's got confidence in his players to step up and, you know, play big-time basketball.
Quick three from somewhere. I'll go. Mountaineers come back the other end. Williams on the work on Gallagher in the paint. Turnaround, tough shot. And they call a foul on Gallagher. And Gallagher puts his hand straight up.
The Catamounts call on the penalty for Blake Gallagher.
There was a guy with his body. It's
the 17th foul.
And Appalachian State, they're the ones trying to work the inside here.
The line shooting keeper, Appalachian State, number 50, Andre Williamson.
Yeah, they're getting physical, they're getting to the foul line, you know, and they're picking up the fouls. I mean, you know, they have a 4-point lead right now, and, you know, a 5-point lead would mean the biggest for either team.
Williamson knocks down the first free throw. Another one upcoming. As Richie Gordon will check out of the ballgame, Twoski King coming back.
Coming into the Catamounts, number 32,
and don't lose any physicality at all. Twoski King will get physical with the best of them.
Yeah, he will. He may not be as tall, but he is just as physical. He's not going to let any easy baskets go. He will get physical.
A big, strong high. And he'll check in on the Catamounts here. 20 points to go. Free throw is good. Largest margin in the ballgame thus far, similar to bring it up for the Catamounts.
Yeah, the Catamounts, they need to get a score right here. They don't want this lead to get too high. They need to get a score and trim it back down to four.
Back to Kowalski. King down low. He is hammered on the way up. Good work between he and Gallagher there, passing back and forth against the double team.
Yeah, he uses strength. Like we just said, he's a big guy. He uses strength right there and, you know, made and forced Appalachian State to commit a foul.
Foul out of the floor. Don't make one strike. Kowalski King at the line. When you come back.
Athletics would like to thank these sponsors for being loyal supporters of Catamount Athletics. Zaxby's, the official chicken sandwich of the Catamounts, and sponsor of the 3-Point Tees. Catamount Peak Apartments, the provider of today's Meet App t-shirts. Catamount Peak Student Housing the way it should be. Catamount Peak Student Community, it's a great place to live. And the Rolling Stone Burrito, the home of the Tucker Taco and Fire in the Hole Taco, and the official sponsor for the 100-point free taco giveaway. The WC Department of Athletics thanks you for your support of Catamount Basketball.
Yeah, he had a good look. It was a great pass to him, and he'll be at the free throw line trying to cut this down to 4 points.
For the Catamounts, number 32, Kowalski King.
King at the line will shoot a pair. And he knocked down the free throw. And Mike Williams will come in, give King a few words of encouragement as he gets set for the second free throw. Trying to make advantage. Good job taking advantage of the strong play. The Catamounts get 2 points to strike.
Those two free throws looked great. And for a big man, you know, they look like two really good free throws. Good job putting 2 points on the board.
Mountaineers trying to go to work on the jumbo. They'll swing it cross court. And the Mountaineers will put it in the hands of Sims, someone who hasn't been as hot scoring-wise for the Mountaineers, but Carter certainly has.
Yeah, definitely. You know, I mean, Sims has been on the bench for a while, but, you know, the Appalachian State, they continue to score with the help of Carter.
That Mike Williams may not be doing it all on the scoreboard. Mike Williams is strong.
Yeah, he's doing the little things. And this crowd, when they see an air ball, every time he touches the ball, they say air ball. They'll let him know that he has air ball.
Coming off the bench was White for the Mountaineers, knocking down a triple lead up to 7 for the Mountaineers.
That was a huge bucket for Appalachian State. We need the Catamounts need to answer right now.
Getting it into Richard Gordon. Looking for the jumper foul. He'll shoot a pair as he takes a tumble on the far side.
That was a great post-up by Richie Gordon, getting the foul on Appalachian State.
And
he's now got his third foul. And, you know, Appalachian's now starting to get fouls piling up and some guys in some foul trouble.
How often have we seen it, though? Every time the Catamounts have needed a big answer throughout the season, big number 50, Richard Gordon steps up.
Yeah, I mean, Appalachian State just took a 7-point lead, and we needed to score on that possession because we couldn't let the lead continue. And Richie Gordon, big play and clutch.
And he also capitalized on the charity stripe, cutting the lead back to 5 with 10:58 here in the ballgame.
Gordon knows how important those free throws were. He was not going to let free throws go to waste.
Sims will hand it to Carter. The high end for the Mountaineers here this half. And they'll swing it over the top of Sims. Somewhere on him, what a great matchup that has proven to him. All game long, Gordon comes over to help on the double. Right down low, underneath the pass over Sims for the Catamounts bank. And the pressure and the constant hands on passes by the Catamount defense probably forced that turnover and an unforced error for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, they did. Appalachian saw the guy on the baseline, tried to get it to him, but that pass was just way off.
Somewhere skip pass, Mike Williams, and back to the three.
What a pass right there. And getting into Richie Gordon. Richie Gordon capitalizes, gets the crowd involved, the crowd's loud, huge dunk, 3-point game, great play.
Right on Williams on the outside. He'll come off the ball screen. Coast to coast. Layup, nice play by Appalachian State. Getting an athlete in an isolation situation against Richie Gordon.
Yeah, they did a pick and roll right there, and it worked effectively to get them an easy layup.
Mutombo feeds, guess who? Richie Gordon. Turnaround jump shot. High arcing shot.
Richie Gordon is hot. He's at 6 straight points. Keep feeding him the ball. He's the big guy, hot, and just keep feeding him the ball.
And the Catamounts look off the big fella. And the Wright will try to spot him three. He's had 2 in a row from downtown.
Marcus Wright for 3.
Leads back to 6. Catamounts don't hesitate.
Off Appalachian State, getting a little slow back on defense. Mutombo capitalized, getting a 3 the old-fashioned way. Great job by Mutombo to answer that 3.
He will knock this down. It will cut the lead back to 3. Tumbo gets set for a free throw, trying to create the three-pointer the old-fashioned way. And a good answer that would be for the Catamounts. Great answer after a big ball from right. Catamounts unfazed, beat the Mountaineers 7-4.
Yeah, the Catamounts right now, they are doing really well at the line. I believe they haven't missed one yet, and hopefully that can continue. And even the past three games, they have hit their free throws. Free throws are key, and if we can keep hitting our free throws, it'll definitely help.
Sims, three ball, Richie Gordon. And a timeout from Larry Hunter, or a whistle. We'll see what this whistle's about. And he's talking to Appalachian State's head coach. And we're trying to sort it out, and now we're ready for play. And I think he was just warning the Appalachian State coach of a little chatter that he heard from the Mountaineers. Again, Catamounts down by 6, need a bucket.
Yeah, we definitely need a bucket here. And
Mike Williams!
Struggling steady all game long when you need it. Mike Williams, right on cue, and he picks up the dish of the Catamounts.
That's a huge two by Mike Williams, and you know, he wanted the ball in his hands because he knew he could score, get the ball, and you know, get the lead trend.
And a thing the Catamounts don't want to see, foul rather, away from the ball. I believe we'll send Mike Williams to his fourth foul and Donald Sims to the line. Something that Sims does so well, even though he doesn't have the ball, he can be a scoring threat. Picking up fouls on the defense.
Yeah, I mean, this is not what the Catamounts wanted at all. You know, he's a great free throw shooter, and giving them points is not what we needed right now. And Mike Williams has four fouls.
The Catamounts really need to come quick here. Pretty much all game long and all year long, they need to continue that spell here at home against the rival Appalachian State.
Yeah, definitely. And, you know, Coach took out Mike Williams and Cole came back in. Hopefully Cole can step up and, you know, take the place of Mike Williams, which won't be easy, but he's a good player. I think he can do it.
Cole, he's already hit a couple threes here tonight, so he certainly brings the perimeter game with him. Sims hits the second free throw. Lead back up to 6.
This is a huge possession for the Catamounts, and we could use a score right here. It's not an insurmountable lead. It's a 6-point game, but we need to get control back of the game. Hopefully get it, you know, a score right here.
Sumler looking to take it himself. And the win! Ball skills by Sumler. All the ISO play and didn't disappoint.
That was a great job by Sumler. Great drive, strong drive, and he was quick and he got those points that the Catamounts needed.
Sumler will go back on Sims defensively with Williams on the bench. And Matumbo calling out the defense on the top. And an easy pass. Richard Gordon will get hit with a goal change. But a lot of
the
The Appalachian State, they did a good job with their pick and roll. They got an open shot, and, you know, Gordon tried to defend it, but he was just a little too late.
7:43 to go. Catamounts will try to chip in to a 6-point Mountaineer lead when you come back.
Cooperation. And now we'd like to acknowledge
you. Welcome back to the Ramsey Center. Catamounts with the basketball. Appalachian State offensively really starting to report.
Yeah, definitely. They've had the lead for a while now, and the defense has to stop them. That'll be a key right now, is stopping the Appalachian State offense. We can't afford to trade baskets. They have a 6-point lead. We have to stop them. We can't afford to trade baskets.
The two top scorers for Appalachian State playing as good as advertised. Sims with 16, Carter with 18, and Carter has been absolutely on a fire run here in the second half.
Yeah, he has. He hasn't let the Catamounts, you know, stop him from scoring, and he's getting hot.
Richie Gordon fouled inside. He will go back to the charity stripe. And Richie Gordon, time and time again, the Catamounts seem behind the eight ball. You see the ball in his hands an awful lot.
Yeah, he's the senior on this team, him and Mike Williams. Mike Williams on the bench. That ball has got to go to Richie Gordon. He'll make a big play. He knows how important this game is, and he won't, you know, let the team down.
Richie Gordon knocks down the free throw. Catamounts cut it back to 5. And really, when you talk about what you want to see in a rivalry game that is hyped as much as this one has been,
Appalachian State certainly has put that UNCG loss behind them. And the Catamounts, it's been an all-out battle here so far this afternoon.
Yeah, it has. I believe that Appalachian State has used that UNCG game and used it as a tool to fire them up against the Catamounts. Not that they really need firing up since it's a rivalry, but coming off a loss, they're going to be trying that much harder.
The Catamounts applied a little bit of full court pressure there, trying to give the Mountaineer offense a different look. They'll swing it aside. Boggs now on Sims defensively. One thing I like that the Catamounts defense is doing, they're giving Sims an awful lot of looks to this guy.
Yeah, they are. You know, they're not letting them, you know, get comfortable and trying to do anything they can to stop them.
And
they're going to call a foul on the Catamounts on the alley-oop attempt. That was
Or
it'll be a 1-1 at one receiving
Williamson.
Andre Williamson will look to make it two shots with his first free throw here and extend the Mountaineer lead. Free throw back there, no good. Appalachian State with a rebound.
For Appalachian State, that was a huge rebound for them. You know, he missed the free throw, but now they get the ball back. Huge rebound.
Woods with Cole on him defensively swings it over to Carter. That is Sims. The two scoring threats that have been on fire this half. Sims does it again. A tough left-hand teardrop off the glass.
Yeah, he drove right to the basket and, you know, got the layup that he wanted.
Summer initially tried to hurry it up for the Catamounts, and now they'll slow up the offense. Cole to the rack. He is fouled, almost got it to go. But he learned it from the line.
Mountaineers foul of Mr. Zero Double Sims, his fourth personal.
Catamounts won't see this guy at the free throw.
It's the 15th foul of Appalachian State.
Sims just picked up his fourth foul. That is huge for the Catamounts. Getting him out of the game is a huge lift.
Cole, a 69% free throw shooter. So two big playmakers for both of these teams. Got him with four fouls. Sims for Appalachian State. Mike Williams for the Catamounts.
And so this is the point of the game. When you've got guys on the bench because of fouls, you see who can step up. And Cole just hit those both free throws, and they looked good. And, you know, he's a 69% free throw shooter, which is, you know, pretty good. But he made those two free throws, and they looked pretty.
Back to a four-point game, and now you would think for Appalachian State, their main facilitator on offense will be Carter, and he hadn't disappointed at all tonight.
No, he hasn't. He's got, you know, he's got a lot of points for the Appalachian State. We need to get the ball out of his hands and make it difficult.
And the Catamounts took it away. Catamounts race down the court, and Summer will pull it back out. And again, Catamounts defense doing a great job getting the turnover since out of basketball.
And that's exactly what we needed. You know, we couldn't trade baskets, and we needed the I can barely hear myself think. This crowd is going crazy. It's down to a two-point game now. Defense just got a big turnover and a big score on the other end.
And Frank has to make sure that he's still realizing the Sims has the game. And someone's feeling like
layup that happened to miss, but Ricky Gordon is right there, as always, put the
basket. How long do you leave him on the bench with those four fouls, only 5:35?
With 5 minutes left, I mean, you can't keep him on the bench very long. You know, they're both big-time players, and you have to trust that they can keep, you know, fouling out of the game. You got to put him back in. The leaders on the team, they gotta be on the
floor. Appalachian State a short time ago. Now only 2 points. Donald Sims leaving the basketball game 4 points under the
definitely. We took advantage of him being out of the game. We looked at it and said, hey, he's out of the game. Let's look at the let's get a mismatch. Let's take advantage. And that's exactly what we did.
Action time.
Catamounts, 13-13 from the charity stripe. That could be huge coming down the stretch.
Definitely. Those free throws, you've got to hit those. And we have been on target all game long.
Appalachian State, 14-19 from the line at 73.7%. Crowd on their feet as Appalachian State will bring the ball across the timeline. Switch, loose ball, skies in the air. Williamson brings it down to the Mountaineers. Double team comes. Catamounts rotate over on Woods. And that's the offense to 14.
Yeah, they're not letting anything happen. You know, there's 2 seconds on the clock, and, you know, they're not letting them get any open shots. It's going to be a really tough shot the Appalachian State's going to have. They're just going to have to shoot it up. There's only 2 seconds left.
Here the Catamounts have got to look for Carter. There is time to catch and shoot that in. Carter is good. Tough three won't go. Sumner grabs the rebound.
And this is a huge possession for the Catamounts. We can either tie it up or even take a one-point lead with a three. And if we score right here, the crowd's gonna go crazy.
Oh, Gordon takes for everybody out here. Fast break opportunity for them. Swings it outside, Carter thought about a three. Comes in, won't go off the back line. And a good stretch to stand by the cap. Bob, COA, spins, right hand, catch.
What a huge play by Bob. He hit the spin move, great layup, great move by Bob. What a play. The place is going crazy. And you look right now, Mike Williams and Sims are ready to come in the game. The Stars are coming back in with 4 minutes left.
Almost intercepted by Richard Gordon. Got up on the side. And foul. Richard Gordon, no chance at the end wall.
No, definitely not. That's a very hard foul. He wasn't going to let him get that basket. Not going to let him get a big three-point play. He'll have to go and earn it from the line.
Williamson slow to get up. It's getting physical in the Ramsey Center. Not enough. 4 minutes to go. Come back and finish.
Yeah, definitely. The fans knew this would be a good game. Everybody knew it would be a good game. There was definitely not going to be a blowout by either team. It would come down to 4 minutes left in the game. Tied up. I don't know what's going to happen. I'm on the edge of my seat. Great game. Great game to watch. And it's going to come right down to the wire.
Again, great resilience from this Catamount team. Down to 7 at 1 point. Right there, way back. Didn't feel like they had to get it all back at once. 3:57 to go in their own building. They're tied up with the Appalachian State Mountaineers.
Exactly. Like you said, they didn't have to get all one. They just chipped away point by point back at the lead, and it's now a tied game.
Williamson sets. First free throw is good. And in confident fist pump from Carter. There's all these free throws coming down the stretch. Huge doesn't describe how big they are.
No, it definitely doesn't. You got to make the 3 points, and every point you can get helps. It'll end up probably being a 1 or 2 point game at the end, so you got to capitalize.
And as you called before the break, free throws good. Sims and Mike Williams back in. If you're Summer, if you're the Catamounts, I'd really like to see him take a right at Donald Sims.
Definitely. Sims is guarding Sumler right now. Try to pick up that fifth foul on it.
Sumler knows it. Goes at him. Jump shot. Sims knowing he has 4 fouls. And Appalachian State seeing the struggles in that pad offensively. Got to be careful not to pick up the fifth. Great job. Easy for Sumler.
Yeah, he did. You know, he kind of backed off a little bit. You know, tried to stay with him. Played the best defense he could without fouling.
Carter blocked. His first. So Catamounts very fortunate to start. Because that's a play though by the defense.
Yeah, definitely. He got, you know, he got ball, but he also got part of the body too, and it will send Appalachian to his free throw line.
Carter at the free throw line, and they tie game 3:45. Here we go. Free throw.
Yeah, he missed that one, and like we said earlier, you got to capitalize with every free throw you can. That could be a huge missed free throw right there.
He buries that one. 1 point game, and we've seen this song before in this game. 1 point back and forth.
Yeah, earlier it was a 1 point back and forth game. I don't even know how many lead changes. Too many to count. And here it is again.
Mountaineers playing a little offense, defense. Sims goes to the bench. The play defense, the free throw, offensive rebound lost by the Catamounts. Appalachian State will come back the other way. Sims still on the bench for the Mountaineers. Interesting decision by the head coach.
Yeah, definitely. You know, they don't want him to pick up that foul. They saw that we were attacking him. And, you know, they definitely don't want that fifth foul.
Kick out pass, Carter will drive on someone. Quick pass back over to Williamson. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Carter, tough shot. Get out of the hole. Bob.
Williamson inside, fighting his way. Oh, to the left.
It's a great rivalry, and it's going right down to the wire.
Mike Gordon, basketball. Gets it over to Gordon. Let's go close. 10 on the clock. 8 on the clock. Gordon!
Mike Williams puts it to win!